What if I told you that the difference between coming across as an arrogant prick or a normal human being is only 1 inch? 2.54 centimeters. Let's put this to a test. Turn towards your neighbor and say, "Hi, nice to meet you." And then you do it one more time, but this time you lift your nose up 1 inch. See if you can spot the difference. Try it now. Go ahead. Thank you. Excellent. Thank you. Thank you for letting me influence your actions. Influence is leadership. And leadership is power. Power to change, power to move, power to make people do what you want them to. And when you succeed, you feel great. And you do it again, and you get a rush, and you do it again, and again, and again. And this is exactly the time where you should humbly realize that you are hooked to the sweet taste of influence and power. Otherwise, you risk becoming that arrogant prick with a nose in the air, having a different behavior and communication style than what brought you to be a leader. And you say things like, "Let's keep the fruit baskets on the executive floor. And we take it away for the employees because, let's face it, the financial times are hard." And you book a business class seat on the plane and you sit there in the front of the plane while all your people parade back to coach. And you say, "You know what? The windows in my corner office are dirty." But your people, they sit in a crowded landscape. Don't think for a second, that this will go unnoticed. Your behavior communicates volumes. Communication is not only what you say. Communication is what you think. It is what you say. But most of all, it's what you do. How you behave. And if you start to behave and communicate differently, based on your own selfish reasons instead of the people you're there to serve, people will do two things. First of all, they will be demotivated. They will work less and with less effort, and that will eventually be shown in the bottom line. The second thing is that they will force you off the throne. Your power and your influence will be gone, dead, buried. And I assume you don't want to die, do you? Of course you don't want to die, you want to live. You want to be a world-class leader, but then you need to be a world-class communicator. There's no way around it. Great leadership demands great communication. I say it again. Great leadership demands great communication. So how can you then behave and communicate in a way that is in tune with your values? I've spent the microphone is a bit wrong, right? The better part of my adult life studying this. I have interviewed leaders, I've been a leader, I've been coaching leaders, and I have found a number of, actually 20 principles, lessons, success factors, truths, and for some people even secrets of human communication that can make you a better leader. And today I would like to share 5 of them. The first 3 are the secret superpowers of communication. If you want us to lead, to follow you, then the first thing you want to do is to communicate with energy. Energy so that we believe that you believe, because why should we if you don't? Energy is mostly visible in your body language and in your voice. And we want to follow you if you show us your passion, your purpose, your glow, your determination. The second superpower is to communicate with empathy. Empathy, so that we feel that you're really trying to understand us. that you get us. Numerous studies have been made on this, asking employees, what do you want from your manager? What do you want? And the one thing they want, you know what it is? Respect. They want to be seen. They want to be listened to. They want their managers to be interested rather than interesting. Empathy creates trust. And the more we trust you, the more we want to follow you. If you don't have empathy, you can be replaced by a computer, because this is what differs us from computers. The third thing is to communicate with clarity. Clarity, so you take away as many misunderstandings as possible, just like Michelangelo took away all the marble around the statue of David. You know that, right? He said, David was inside there all the time. I just took away everything around it. And if you can make us see what you see and hear what you hear and feel what you feel, you have not only reached out, you have reached in. So the best leaders are also the best storytellers. And those are the ones we want to follow. Those were the three superpowers of communication. Now, I'm sorry to say, but there are some challenges as well. And I have got for us tonight. Are you ready for the challenges as well? Is it too boring now? Well, let's go for the challenges. Okay, good. The first challenge is that everything about you communicates. You cannot decide not to communicate. You can't say, you know what, I'm in a bad mood. I'm not going to communicate today. Everything communicates. What you say, what you do, what you eat, what you wear, what you drive, what you don't say, do, eat, wear. Everything communicates. And you don't even get the chance to decide what it is. Everyone else decides what you communicate. Is it fair to say that you spend time in meetings? Yes or no? Yeah. If you're a leader, you spend about 50 to 80% of your time in meetings. Let's take this concrete example. If you look like this every time you're in a meeting, and people look at you because you're the leader, you might think that you're signaling efficiency, productivity, high performance. But chances are that your people will think that, I'm obviously less important than whatever is on that screen. How would you like to be described? The second challenge is this. Everybody affects everybody. Have you heard about the theory called 6 degrees of separation? It says that everyone knows everyone on the planet within 6 steps. It also means that we infect or affect everyone on the planet within 6 steps. Now, I don't personally know Lady Gaga, but I have a friend who knows a producer who knows Lady Gaga. So basically, I know her too. And you do as well, right? Now, if Lady Gaga is... This is Lady Gaga. This is Lady Gaga, dressed in her casual clothes. If she's in a good mood, she will infect and affect the producer, and he will be 15% happier, thanks to her. And then he will meet my friend, and she will be 10% happier, thanks to her. And then she will meet me, and I will be 5% happier, thanks to Lady Gaga. Isn't that amazing? Huh? Now replace her with you. You are the person, you're an influencer. I mean, you influence people, you impact people, you're a leader. You're like a rock that plummets into the ocean. And the wave is your influence that touches people way beyond your physical reach. So what you have to decide is whether or not you want to be a tiny grain of sand, or if you want to be a rock, or if you perhaps want to be an asteroid changing the course of the planet. Now, I know you won't remember everything I said, so I will leave you with 2 thoughts. The first one is that great leadership demands great communication. And the second thing is that everything about you communicates. Fruit baskets, business class seats, and even such a small thing as rising, lifting, or lowering your nose 1 inch. Thank you.